Hello guys and welcome to my channel. Today I'm gonna show you how you can overclock your Intel i9-10900K CPU having an Asus motherboard. I have an Asus Z490-E Gaming. All you have to do is to go to AI Tweaker and in the AI Overclock Tuner you have to select your XMP profile. I used to select XMP number 2 because it's the dim complete default XMP profile. Then you have to go to the CPU core ratio and select sync all cores. Then down below you have the all core ratio limit. You have to put 50 if you want 5 GHz, 49 if you want 4.9 GHz, 51 if you want 5.1 GHz and so on. So basically you have to try to see which one it will work for you. Then you have to go to DG plus VRM. Then you have to select the CPU load line calibration. By default it's set to auto and then the recommended value for OC is number 4. You have to try and test it by yourself and see which one will work for you. If it's number 4 working for you, then you should be happy because the processor will run not so hot. So you'll not need the high-end cooling system or whatsoever. So for me it's working at number 6, I'm happy with it. It never reached more than 80 degrees. Then you have to go to internal CPU power management. Here you have to change the CPU core cache current limit maximum. You just insert 9999, it will give you the maximum. Long duration package power limit, the same. You include 9999, it will give you the maximum. And short duration package power limit, the same thing. And then we go back to the previous menu. Next, you go to the CPU minimum cache ratio and maximum CPU cache ratio. Here you start from 45 until 48 and see which one works for you. Then you have to go to CPU core cache voltage, select manual and start from, I don't know, maybe 1.25 and up. The maximum, in my opinion, the maximum should be not more than 1.35, but I don't think you'll reach that high voltage. Yeah, depends on what type of motherboard do you have. But then for me it's working 1.27. Next, below, it's the DRAM voltage. I used to put 1.35 and then to overclock just a little bit my memory. My maximum stability, it's on 1.35 and then 3733 megahertz. So I'm happy with the results. And I will keep it this way. I'm not looking for more than this. Next, another advice. This is I saw many people didn't knew this, but of course if you look into the manual, it's written this detail. It's written there. So you have to, if you have an NVMe SSD. You have to install it at a M.22 slot. Is the one below. In this case, in this for this motherboard Z490E Gaming, you have to select to run at 4x instead of 2x because otherwise it will run at half of the speed. Your SSD will be very slow, and like this. It will have it run you will have it running at full speed. Another thing is if you have a temperature sensor in your case, you have to go and configure your fans. So you go to fan control and let the system to optimize all the fans. In my case, it does very good job, and I'm very happy with the automatical optimization. And that's it. Now we are going to go into the Windows and run some CPU stress. And I will show you also the temperature right next to the test. So for the temperature, I will use the core temp application, and for the CPU stress, I will use core mark. I can see I have to make an update, but doesn't matter now. So I'll make a CPU burner test for 5 minutes, and you can see the values. The processor is running at 5 GHz, so the power consumption is not more than 190 watts. As you can see, after 5 minutes, the maximum temperature on core 6 it's 80 degrees, on core 4 it's 79, and core 2 78. Nowhere more than 80 degrees, and this will be kept for a long time. Of course, it does matter the temperature in your room. In my case, there are 21 degrees. And I have an Asus TUF 501 case. So it's a mid tower case, but it's pretty big anyway. And I have a lot of coolers. I have 3 120 millimeters on top, one 140 millimeters in the back. So these ones are as exhaust, and as intake, it's the 4 push-pull configuration with the radiator from the processor AIO. So this is the intake, and the exhausts, it's on top and in the back. Next, I'm going to run a memory test stability. It's the program, it's memtest for 64 bits. Here you run indefinitely at maximum memory, tested memory, and I will let it run two loops, and then if I got no errors, then we will go ahead and jump to the final step. So now you see The test run two loops and start the third one. Nothing happened, no errors, no nothing. Now I will show you what's the best position for the cooler, the processor cooler inside your case. Here you will see my case and my CPU cooler installed there. As you can see, the cables are going in the bottom side and not the top side. And my top radiator, it's higher than the CPU cap. This is the best position and always will be the best, and not the other way, or I don't know, not with the hoses on the top and or the radiator lower than the cooling cap. And because it's logic and it's physics, when you have also, in my case now my GPU is missing, but you will understand anyway. Basically, the hot air it's easier than the cold air. So if you have the cooler, CPU cooler installed on top as exhaust, then all the heat from GPU, which makes the most heat in the computer case, will go into your CPU cooling radiator, and that's not good. Even though you can say you have fans installed as intake and blah blah blah, it will not work. The best position is on the intake in the front, and you have to have the exhaust on top and in the backside, so all the hot air will get out as fast as possible without being blocked by any other radiators or anything else. Hot air being easier than the cold air will raise immediately as it is released. So the fans will take it out in the fastest way possible. So in order to have the best results and in order to have the coolest system, you have to install it this way. And then when you install, make sure when you install the cooling cap on the processor, before putting it there and into the final position, make sure to raise the radiator in order to have all the air getting out from the pump and the cooling cap, and to have all the air stuck into the radiator in the top side, and make sure to install it higher than the cooling cap. And like this, no air will be left in the cooling cap on the processor, and the water will be constantly sent to cool the CPU without having air bubbles and whatever. So I think this is it. Hope this was helpful for you, and see you on my next video.